Welcome to this presentation where we're going to take a quick look at using Windows 8. So we're going to start off with the install, and we've got the developer preview here. So as normal, we're going to have to select our locale, and then we have the install now button, and as you can see, then the setup process is starting. As with Windows 7, it's going to boot into Windows PE and run the setup program from Windows PE. So we accept the license agreement. I've nothing on this machine, so it's going to be an install, and this looks pretty normal. And I can use a Shift and F10 button to access the WinPE prompt if I would need to, such as creating a virtual disk to install to. So all of this is pretty much the same, and then we continue with the install, and this is just going to take a few minutes to run through. So the process during the installation is pretty much the same thing. It's image based. Once it's applied the image, it reboots as we see now. And we're running through the specialization phase of the Windows setup. We're detecting the hardware. And then the machine will reboot again and we'll jump into the out-of-box experience. As we start up then into the out-of-box experience, we're setting up the PC name. We can run through either customize setting or we can use the express settings, which will take the defaults. A lot of it is allowing locations and application customization, such as allowing account pictures, etc. So very much fitting what we're used to within the online world. So we're going to use the express settings for our installation. Now to log on, we can use a Windows Live ID, so it really integrates our user account with our Windows Live ID. So I'm going to enter the information. Or we could log on using standard accounts, but I'll log on using my Live ID, but I'll just hide the settings that I use. So you just put in your Live ID and password, and then you can see that I've logged on as Andrew Mallett. So this is the Metro interface. We can access a lot of our applications through this interface. So clicking on the weather channel, of course, is going to fire up weather. And we can see the temperature currently in Anaheim. We can move back to the bottom right hand corner, access our Windows menu, and we can click on the desktop. And this will present us perhaps what we're used to, but this isn't a start menu. This is, if you like, the Metro. If I click on that, that will take me back. But if I move to the very bottom left hand corner, it's going to give me an additional menu where I can then search, share, set up devices, or go into my Windows settings. So the very bottom left hand corner of the Metro button allows me to access things like the settings. I can go through to my network settings here. I can move back. Again, the bottom left hand corner is going to bring up my settings. Or click on the button will take me through to the Metro interface. Again, going back into settings now, so from the bottom left hand corner of the Metro button, clicking back onto settings. If I wanted to, then I could move to the power button where I could then power down or reboot. Again, clicking on the Metro button, the start button now really gives me the Metro interface. I can move across to the Andrew icon. This is where I could customize my icon, log on, log off, or add more users to the system. We can also customize the taskbar as we've been used to. By going back to my desktop and then on the taskbar, obviously going to the properties. On the jump to list, we can always add in applications that we've accessed, and we can put in the address and the desktop shortcut onto the taskbar. With the address, then I can go in and type something like C:\, and then that will take me into Windows Explorer. Clicking on the clock will show me I got very much the Windows 7 style of clock. I go into it, change my date and time settings. I can add additional clocks as required. So now we're finished with our quick preview. We will shut the machine down, so go into the bottom left hand corner of our start button, go into our settings, and then the power button. Hopefully you found this useful, and you can be certain there are going to be more videos coming your way soon on Windows 8. Now we start learning.